though. I don't know if many of you are into candles or not, but we have this candle that I absolutely love, called Lonely Mountain, and it smells absolutely amazing. We found them on Etsy at Epic Adventure Candle Co. It has a wooden wick, so it like crackles when it's burning, and it's like, it's not overpoweringly fragrant. It smells wonderful, and it's enough to like fill the room with the scent. Might take me about a few months. I wanted to see about how hard it would be to get costume leather, Charizard helmet. So, a lot of times for armors, pink, because the person's not like in front of me, and it's hard to make custom pieces for all kinds of different body sizes, I do usually use patterns. I have all kinds of different patterns. So we would probably start with a base pattern and then work from there. It all depends on the amount of detail. And as far as the Charizard helmet, I actually have a pretty good idea for that. I have a pattern for a dragon mask. I actually have a couple patterns, but with a recoloring, something like this might work out pretty well. Wow, it's raining. I don't know if you guys can hear that or not. There's so many different variables for pricing. Like chest pieces usually start around 700. Shoulders usually start at about 150 for two shoulders. Bracers can be as low as, I think 65 for a set of bracers. Am I late to the party? No, not overly late. I've only been streaming less than 20 minutes. You're good. You're good, Gig. So, Pink, starting with a pattern like this for the Charizard helmet might be something you're interested in. I have a couple different ones as well. In May, hello! Howdy, howdy. How are you recovering from the... You're back on the phone, something to go. Okay, I'm back. All right, Pink. I'm recovering pretty well. Grab my wallet and keys to give the person who commissioned this a better look at the size. Back working at the Amazon warehouse, very nice. Lady Blue Dragon! Oh, perfect! Yeah, and I also have a couple other different, like, dragon helmet patterns as well. What you working on? I got a couple things I'm working on. So this was a prototype, like hit bag that I actually made the pattern for yesterday, and I put together on stream last night. Also made some Fenrir stamps yesterday. I just did some really quick stamping, and then I sewed it with the machine. Just to see how, like, the... everything would come out. If anyone wants the pattern, let me know, and I'll put it in Discord. Got some Stream Raiders going on too. Going through the dungeons for Stream Raiders. Oh, what was I gonna work on? I think I was gonna work on, I need to make some scraps. Thank you. How many months in advance do you need to let you use metal armor to make it for next year's TwitchCon? You're willing to fly over once I'm ready to get measurements. I would say probably at least 3 months. Another armor. I was hoping to have this one done for TwitchCon. This one's kind of been just sitting around for a while. Still amazing. Thank you, Hinmei. Here's the thing I was looking for. Oh, camera's going crazy. Sorry. If I don't reply right away, I'm adulting at work, so I have to be careful. No problem, Pink. Make sure, take care of yourself. Your job's more important than anything. I really appreciate the lurk. I really do. Medieval car keys. Blombox, how's it going? Yeah, hey, man, that's gonna be awesome.
Bye bye.
You were enjoying them?
Yeah! Yeah, I definitely know that feeling. Burnish these edges. All right, right now I'm putting together the bottle holder. I'm not even really making a pattern for it. I'm kind of just freehanding it. Science. Great meeting you at the con, man. We're doing good. Elba's at work right now. Yeah, just getting back into the swing of everything. I'll be able to stream during the days a lot more now. We'll have some stream raiders and leather working in the mornings. Hey, do more leather stuff. Okay, I will do more leather stuff.
That's coming together nicely.
I'm gonna go with the armored units gain 40% more healing. Because it seems like right now we're kind of want to be focusing our vampire. Give it a big old buff. How hard are satchel bags? Not very hard. It depends on, like, do you mean like a motorcycle bag or a horse satchel? What kind of satchel bag are we talking here? Or like a hip satchel bag? I guess, show me a picture and I'll, back hip satchel, like the if you go onto my Etsy store, you can see I have a like a hip bag on there. I don't know if that's what you're looking at or you're interested in. Oh, and it's on the back of his body. Okay. Wouldn't be too terribly hard. I'd have to make a custom pattern for that, but it would be doable. Is the stream raiders big enough for you guys to see? Probably, actually, I need to post, post my... Anything's doable for the right price. What the heck? Are there drops currently activated for stream raiders? Battle.
Sure thing.
Got it.
Sorry. Loud noises. Glad to have met you at TwitchCon. Oh, Maestar! Welcome, welcome! Glad to have met you too. I must say that I am horrible with names and faces. I'm better with faces. Horrible with names. But I was glad to meet you too. TwitchCon was an amazing time. Trip home was good. Yeah, trip home was actually pretty easy since we're based in Orange County. So by the time we left, it was only about an hour drive. Or hour 20 minutes. And we stopped for some Korean barbecue on the way home. So we were a little upset when we got home. Got home around 11 o'clock at night, and the babysitter had not put the kids to bed. So we had to deal with very cranky children in the morning. Consummate, what's up? Oh no. Glad to see you survived the ball pit. Well, I mean, if you had some +3 leather armor. Yeah. I yeah. I actually went to the ball pit at like time that the doors open. Doors opened at like 9. I think I was there at like 8:40 in the ball pit. I think the accident happened at like 10. You heard about what happened at TwitchCon, right? The whole ball pit incident, or the foam pit. Somebody broke their back. Yeah, it was like a compound fracture, or it was a not a compound fracture. It was a compression. That's the word.
they have metal posts under the floor.
Like, when we were on the foam, it didn't seem that bad. But also, I didn't really ground pound the foam with my tailbone to find out either. Just didn't seem like a good idea. Twice without injury, right? See if I can push the... Someone.
Somebody might have died.
Oh, consummate. So I purchased the belt roller that you linked to me through Ivan the other day. Eager to receive that. Purchased it actually with the some of the TwitchCon funds.
The units have 25% more damage.
No, that was actually Sabrina. So, that's the fiance of the person I was fighting. She's a very close friend of hers. It's actually Rin. Rin is her username. She's one of our mods as well. They both came to TwitchCon to help us out, help us run our booth the whole time, and it was fantastic having them to help.
TwitchCon was so much fun.
Yes.
know where it will be next year. So from, oh, update available. Thank you for letting me know, Consummate. What I had heard rumored was they're going to try to do it in Las Vegas. Welcome, Foxy Detroit. All right, it's going to take a few minutes for that game to update, it looks like. Buy my tickets once I know where it's going to be. Yeah, but that was the rumor that I was hearing around from some of the partners that were in the Artist Alley. Not 100% sure, but I mean, I'd be down for Las Vegas. That'd be kind of cool. I also heard that they have less restrictions on like the venues and stuff there too. But we're definitely looking forward, since this was our first con, and it was such an amazing experience because we met so many amazing people. A lot of you are in chat. we definitely want to start doing more cons. I don't know if anyone watched the cosplay competitions or not, but one of my friends, Faye Paints, actually won the armor category. Oh dear, this isn't good. Oh no! Wait, SBL. That's not Springfield leather. Right? Not the weekend though. if you're referring to my streaming schedule, getting an error for StreamWriters. We just enrolled our youngest in preschool, so I will have time to stream. If we can. StreamWriters doesn't want to work right now. More cons for you? Yes. Maybe if I do it through the browser?
Did you get a lot of sales? Yes, we did get a lot of sales. We actually... just about everything that Elva prepared for the con sold. Alright, loud noises. Gotta punch two holes. Loud noises, apologies in advance. Probably gonna get destroyed. So I looks like I was able to get the battle to work on the browser. So hopefully after the browser, I'll be able to switch it back to the actual app. If you saw Consummate, but Amarath, was it? I think is that how you say her name? She stopped by and then she did like a meet and greet, kind of an unofficial meet and greet outside of our booth for like 10 minutes. So on her stream, I'm just in the background getting my hair braided. Thank you.
Oh yeah, we were in Hassan. I don't know his full name, but he came by and he tried on our armor. I wasn't at the booth at that time, which I feel bad about because I would have been able to help out Elva a little bit more. She was I know she was feeling overwhelmed with that huge crowd that kind of just showed up. Where is my poker? I need my all. Actually, I suppose I could just. Yeah. Honestly, the streamer I felt best about meeting, and I didn't even. I've never. I don't really. I don't really watch the other streamers very much, like the big time streamers. We're mostly stick to the makers and crafting community. But a streamer by the name of A Gassy Mexican stopped by, and I didn't know who he was until after he left the my booth. But he was genuinely interested in getting some armor made, and he mentioned, if it's no problem if I need to fly out for a fitting and everything. And he even gave me one of those NFC cards, programmed with my link tree on it, which was so cool. He seemed like a really nice, down-to-earth guy. Go with antique copper. You know, I think I saw that Tandy has like actual shiny copper rivets. I think I might go get some of those for this. Yeah, I think the shiny copper rivets would really pop out on this if I can find those. You had Amaroth step on you. What do you guys think? Should I try to get rivets that match this color? Or just go with the I suppose we could do the antique copper or the antique brass. Actually, how does regular brass look? Oh, regular brass would probably be too shiny. I don't think you'd like that very much. So we got antique brass. Antique copper. Or I could try going and getting rivets that match this color. We got boss battle. I think after I die on dungeons, I'm gonna switch back over to the regular Stream Raiders game mode. I'm just gonna get it done. I think I'm hurting myself by not getting some of these projects completed. The dream projects of yours you want to make? One of the next things that I'm going to start working on, since I'm going to be able to like start making a schedule for everything, is the Elven Lord armor from Prince Armory. That's definitely going to be a big project. And it's going to require me to use a lot of my skills that I've been acquiring over the years leatherworking. As far as like dream projects, like being able to work on movies, I think like anything fantasy related would be a dream come true. When we got to work on the show Lucifer, that was definitely a dream. Thank you. Yeah, that was, so the Lucifer armor was, that was another Prince Armory pattern. Reference. And I actually kind of put together the tacit belt about the same time that he released it too.
Yay! The ones who made Lucifer's armor versus Michael.
Yes, technically we made Michael's armor. But that was a dream, really. And then honestly, like, it's really awesome being able to look at something on the screen and say, like, I was involved in that. And it's a feeling that brings a lot of pride for me. There's going to be another upcoming show, National Treasure on Disney Plus, which I made a couple bags for. And I think it's, judging by the description I was given for like the bag and its purpose, it sounds like it might be featured a good amount in the show. Mork making all the props. Yep. Pretty sure you're supposed to get props and not sell them, right?
In that case, I better get saving up so I can get my armor ordered before you guys get too busy. Right? Do you mind if I'm vulnerable for a minute? Sure, Inmei. This is a safe place.
Didn't warn myself of loud noises. Yeah. Now my neck's like all tensed up. Oh, that's what happened. Wifo. Camera's following me too. Cool. How did you break the light? Well, nothing's technically broken. This is a very enlightening moment. Oh gosh. Mark, the light is literally hanging from the ceiling. Right, but it's not broken. All right, hang on 1 second. I gotta take a call. I will be right back. Oh, never mind.
Somebody clip that. Oh gosh. I think the main reason why I have imposter syndrome is because people who saw my works growing up, they only judge me off of those works that I did then, not the ones that I do now, so I feel like I haven't made it yet, even though I get constant jaw drops every time people see my works. Yeah. I can relate there. Like, it still feels weird that the whole Lucifer thing even happened. I would say it not being on the ceiling is broken, but it's still working, right? Missed the moment. No, it didn't suck. Oh, I guess you did miss the moment, huh? My neck tensed up when that happened, so I have like a Charlie horse in my neck now. Oh, thanks, Inme. Let's do more attack speed. Honestly, I think I'd rather have it hit me than have a Charlie horse, because like those things are super lightweight. Alright, where was I? I want to make all the things. Yes. Have too many patterns saved to buy on Etsy. There's no such thing. Get out of here with your too many patterns. Just kidding.
thought it was 7 patterns per month and never took any of them.
Aw, thank you, Hen.
I missed some stuff, sorry. Remember, folks, buy a pattern and make one thing at a time.
Right.
Then you could sell your practice piece and end up with all the patterns.
Yep, that is true. Yep.
Those 3 patterns for every item made.
I mean, you're not supposed to use the money to buy just patterns and not more materials so you can make the patterns.
Let's round up to 10.
Yes.
My units.
Somebody put down a healer quick.
People, it seemed, or a lot of people seem to have a lot of fun with the fact that we offered to let people try on the armor. So I think that's going to be another thing we aim for in the next cons is to have. I'm probably going to bring my Viking armor next time, and then I want to get a female armor done as well so that people have multiple options to try.
Charge $5 to wear it? No.
Maybe.
Fantastic. Oh yeah, thank you.
Yeah, we're super fortunate to have such awesome, helpful friends.
So the female that was wearing the armor, that wasn't actually hers. She was borrowing that from another friend of ours. But she's actually wants to commission me to do the female Elven Lord from Prince Armory once it's available.
Thank you for the stretch, Elven Lord Armor.
Right, right.
From which series? So the Elven Lord is a it's a pattern series from Prince Armory. Prince Armory is where the armor that I use most of the time is from his patterns. Prince Armory does absolutely jaw-dropping work. Like, his suits of armors start at 15k. Hydrate! Thank you for the hydrate. Alright, I will hydrate with some coffee. That's hydrating, right? Let me see. Alright, let me show you. Okay, here's the pattern. I need to figure out how to get the drop. Okay. Have you got drops turned on?
Emotional, damn it!
I think I do have drops. I have an academy. I have the Black Raven Academy courses, but I haven't gotten very far yet. Yeah. They it's not really an academy so much. Alan Slate or Alan Z. So. Let's put it this way. So Black Raven, he's more of a, I would almost say like theoretical educational approach, right? Because with Black Raven Academy, you start out and you go over like what is art? What are patterns? What are naturally occurring things that you see in your environment? And then it takes a while before you get into the hands-on stuff. Prince Armory is more of the hands-on approach. You can buy the pattern, watch the video, see all of his techniques, how he does it, how he applies it to the leather, and just go from there. They're two different methods of approaching something. And like I was saying last night, it's leather crafting is an art and not a science, so there's multiple ways to do something. I really like Prince Armory because it's very cut and paste. Like, this is what you're doing, and he goes over exactly how to do it. But there's the link to the Elven Lord. Also, shameless plug. Somewhat shameful plug, but if you are interested in buying like the Prince Armory patterns, if you do click on my link, I am affiliated with Prince Armory, and I'm also affiliated with Black Raven Academy. So if you purchase either of their patterns, I will get a little bit of a kickback for referring you guys. Can't join battle, sorry, already doing dungeons and it won't let me do two captains. Oh, sorry, Wish. I think I should be done with dungeons pretty soon. I'm just going until I lose, because it is hard to keep going. The every 5 minutes thing is a little difficult. When melee units get a kill, they attack the closest nearby enemy for an extra hit. Ooh. Where attacks leave flames dealing damage to nearby enemies. Armor break. Melee units reduce 20% defense. I do the melee. Yeah. Yes, it's hard to get any work done in dungeons. Exactly. Took my first commission recently, making a sporran for a friend's wedding. Awesome! But as far as the Elven Lord goes, I believe I do have all of the patterns. So I can get started on the Elven Lord.
Actually, I wonder if I have the female yet. Another pattern that I wanted to do was the Alexander the Great from the Fate series. If anyone's ever seen the Fate series, Alexander the Great is one of the characters I really wanted to cosplay. Hinmei, thank you for coming in. Awesome talking to you. We'll talk to you, or hopefully talk soon. Hopefully see you again soon. Doesn't look like the... Okay, so it says the female pattern, or the female breastplate, is still in progress for the Elven Lord. But man, I'm looking forward to making that. But I think what I'm planning on doing is dedicating at least like one day out of the week to just working on the Elven Lord. Like maybe like every Tuesday I'll work on the Elven Lord. Every Wednesday I'll maybe every Wednesday. I don't know. I have to figure out my streaming times and everything. Cuz I also want to, once I'm a little less busy, I want to start going back to the gym again too. We got like 2 minutes left on the dungeons. We could use maybe some ranged. Also, if anyone has recommendations for, since we have unlocked a full skin for Stream Raiders, please let me know. I had a couple ideas. One of them was Uther as a rogue, dressed up Assassin's Creed style. what was another one? Oh, another one was for a wizard that was Gandalf. So a buff Gandalf wizard. And then what was the other one? Oh, another one was for the artillery. Have it as a ballista operated by a little corgi. Uther War Beasts? Okay. That would be a good one, Uther War Beast.
Right.
You guys see, like, the, I don't know how it looks on mobile, but can you guys see everything on the stream readers okay? Do you want me to make it bigger? Would you rather I be going full screen? How many people? Oh no, we lost a lot of people. Lots of casualties there. Flying rogues have infinite range and can't move, but are stunned for 10 seconds when they get it to kill. Ooh, 10 seconds, that's a lot. When war beasts kill an enemy, four ally epic skeleton warriors are summoned. Ooh. All units gain 10%. I want to go with the Underworld Beast. I'm not sure if we lost our War Beast last round or not. All right, I'm gonna go with Generalists so that we get more healing. At least I still have my War Beast. That's good. My War Beast is still alive. Okay. Oh, there we go. So, water bottle is done. I can't hear you at work, but what did you break? I didn't break anything. What are you talking about? No, nothing's broken. The lights came down on stream. Right, I'm gonna make a call real quick. I'm be right back, all right? There we go. All right. Sorry about that, everyone. I was talking to the person who ordered like the hip bag and the water bottle. So he also wants me to do two of these style knife sheaths. So this is gonna be super easy. I'm just gonna. That's a super easy reproduction. Okay, all right, so I have like a total of 5 sheaths I have to make. So I have to make 2 sheaths for this. These are gonna be easy because I'm just copying these. And I have to make 3 sheaths for this, it's like a foam CX. Oh no, didn't make it in time. This might be our last battle. I don't know. We got 8 units. We'll see. Looks like somebody is interested in some female Nightingale armor from Elder Scrolls. 5 versus 4. Lost a couple people though. Armor break, we find us. Ranged units' fire rate is increased by 15%. Or 15% more damage. Units reduce 20% defense of this target's own attacks for 8 seconds. Well, the armor break, actually. I think I'll go for the armor break. Because we have a lot of, at least with the war beast. Oh no, my war beast is exhausted. Okay, so he's not dead. I can still use my war beast. So if I can get a war beast and a healer out at the very least, it might be okay. Mm-hmm.
Rampage.
Right, so a little over three. Oh, three and a half. It's between 8 and 9 ounces. Okay. That's more than battle starting in 1 minute. Can I use Adobe Illustrator? Right back. I think I saw a little child using. Oh, there we go. I found it.
We win. Alright, let's see. Victory! Huzzah! Let's see, Rage from Beyond. When a common unit dies, nearby allies gain 100% attack speed and damage for 3 seconds. Ooh. Underworld Beast. When War Beasts kill an enemy, 4 ally epic skeleton warriors are summoned. Ooh, that sounds pretty good too. Oh man. I think Rage from Beyond might be